In our lab, we do research on genomics of malaria mosquitoes. And of course, as you know, malaria is a devastating disease, causing more than 500,000 deaths every year, especially in tropical countries. We are trying to find the way how we can use genomics of mosquitoes to control malaria. The current methods of control is insecticide, but mosquitoes develop resistance very quickly. So we are trying to find some other ways to interfere with mosquito reproduction and biology. So we know how genes are organized in a linear order on chromosomes. What we don't know is how chromosomes and genes are organized in the three-dimensional space of the cell nucleus. But this is very important because we know from similar studies in human or plasmodium malaria parasite that three-dimensional genome organization is very important for gene function.
It is important to investigate genomes, basically to find some specific features of their malaria mosquitoes' genomes, maybe some patterns of genes, like how they, where they're active, where they're inactive in which species. There is a high-C method. It's a chromatin conformation capture technique, and it seems to be really powerful in terms of discovering their chromatin structure, genome structure. So basically how genome is organized within the tiny nucleus. We decided to optimize it for malaria mosquitoes, for anopheles mosquitoes. And because it's like a different objects of research, like totally different size and their cells and everything, I needed to optimize this method. We have some interesting findings in malaria mosquitoes. So they have some very long distance loops, so basically two loci which separated by millions of base pairs, they somehow find each other in the nuclear space and keep these interactions. So, and this is true for all five mosquito species. It makes it easier to get the products, like to get proteins which are necessary for transmitting malaria.
We want to understand at what point and how certain DNA regions get unpacked so they could be accessible and they can be expressed so the gene would work. And before our work, we didn't have this information for mosquitoes. Once we know how genes are regulated, we can employ this information for development of new methods to genetically control mosquitoes.